Evaluating bus stop accessibility, particularly for people in wheelchairs, is Indigo's latest project.
It's rolling out a pilot program to map out problem areas along the anticipated Purple Line. News 8's multicultural reporter Katira Winfrey joins us with that story. Katira.
Brooke and Phil, Indigo volunteers who use wheelchairs and Briometrics, the company providing the equipment to map the data, spent the afternoon working. For people who don't have trouble walking, it's easy to overlook the bumps and cracks. But for others, they feel and see it all.
These guys like to move around, but they don't use their feet.
Now we're on asphalt again.
Wheels get them where they need to go, but the path isn't always smooth.
A lot of people might take things for granted, maybe bypass something that maybe, like, we see a sidewalk or somewhere with truncated domes and we see a small lip. It's nothing for you to walk over, step over, but for us, it could tumble us over out of our chairs into the street.
Brandon Somerville is the field engineer with Briometrics. He's leading efforts to gather data about street and sidewalk conditions along what will eventually be Indigo's Purple Line Corridor, 38 to Post Road.
We can come back here and we have a receiver and our antenna.
He knows how valuable this project is firsthand. He's been in a wheelchair since high school. He and his team are using special equipment to record it all.
There's a lot to mobility, including the bus, but you have to be able to get to the bus stop. So we're really trying to look at what factors are limiting people's access to a bus stop and what we can do to improve that access.
Somerville says on top of the cracks in the ground, they find light poles, mail and electrical boxes blocking the way. While people walking can easily go around them, it's not the case for people who get around like this.
A lot of times individuals will get halfway down the sidewalk, they'll have to turn around back to the stoplight, cross the stoplight and go back down.
But all this isn't just for them, it's for the pregnant mother pushing a stroller, for the person using a crutch, or someone who's blind and needs a cane to feel their way.
And the group isn't done doing mapping just yet. They'll pick back up next week. Indigo will use the data to determine where to improve infrastructure and develop a map that'll show the most accessible routes. Purple Line construction begins next year. Reporting in the studio, I'm WishTV News 8's multicultural reporter, Katira Winfrey.